Ho, 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 and welcome to a special Christmas episode of Wildcat TV on Comcast 15 and ATT U-verse 99.
Eli, that's one special hat you got there.
Yes, yes it is.
We have a special show planned for you here today. To start us off, we go to reporter Kaylee Chapelow with a special guest from the North Pole.
Hi, my name's Kaylee Chapelow, and I'm reporting for Wildcat TV. We have a very special guest on Wildcat TV today. He sees you when you're sleeping, he knows when you're awake, and he knows if you've been bad or good. So be good for goodness sake. Let's take a look. It's Santa!
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
Hello, Santa. We really appreciate you being here. I know you're super busy at the North Pole. You look kind of familiar.
No, I'm Santa Claus.
Okay. Well, we have a couple of people that want to ask you what they want for Christmas. Is that okay?
Sure.
All right, I think we have the first one right here.
Hello, Anton. How are you?
How do you know my name?
Well, Santa knows every boy and girl. I hear the football team did really well this year.
Yeah, well, we went undefeated this year, and we won another state championship, so I think we did really well.
Well, congratulations. That's a great season.
Well, Santa, I have one thing for Christmas that I
would. Yes, tell me what you would like.
It's probably not like an interesting type thing, but I just want a cello.
That's all you want is a cello?
A cello.
I've had a burning desire to play the cello.
Yeah, to play the cello.
Well, you've been a very good boy this year, so I'd like to make your wish come true. Here you go, ask and you shall receive. You've done a great job in school this year. You've been to school every day. You had great attendance at school, and your season was fantastic with the football team.
You got me in trouble. Thank you.
I'm glad you like it.
So, Santa, we have another student here from Blue Springs High School that would really like to meet you.
What would you like to have for Christmas this year?
I would like, I think I want a new cell phone.
Oh my God! It's magical! It's so magical!
Yes.
Oh, oh, oh. She said it! She said the words!
Okay. So what are your goals for next semester?
Well, I want to finish my program in forensics, hopefully successfully, and I would like to finish with a 4.0.
Those are great goals to have, and you're able to accomplish those goals by being in school every day and having great attendance.
Thanks, Santa.
Very important.
Yes, yes, okay.
Last but not least, we have one of our own principals here at Blue Springs High School that wants to ask you what they want for Christmas.
Ho, 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 Merry Christmas. Well, hello there, Mr. Alderman.
Hi, Santa, how are you?
I'm doing great. Here's a little candy cane to wish you Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays.
Thank you.
Mr. Alderman, what would you like for Christmas?
Well, I think on the top of my Christmas list would be a nice red, shiny Mustang. If you could swing that, that would be great.
I'll talk to Mrs. Alderman and see what she thinks about that. Also, would like to know what kind of goals would you like to have for Blue Springs High School second semester?
You know, one of the goals on the top of my list is for our student attendance to improve. We'd love to see our student attendance above 95%. But I think everybody needs to remember that you have to have 90% attendance to go to prom. But for me, I think our goal is 95 or above.
That sounds like a great goal, and I know you're looking forward to a fantastic finish to the school year.
Thanks, Santa. Looking forward to seeing that red shiny car in my driveway.
We'll see about that.
Well, Santa has to get back to his workshop now, but we really do appreciate you being here. Remember, Santa's always making a list and checking it twice, and he will find out if you're naughty or nice. Have a great rest of the semester and have really good finals. Signing off for Wildcat TV, I'm Kaylee Chapelow.
Thanks, Kaylee. I hope all of you have 4.0 GPAs and perfect attendance. Otherwise, you'll be eating some coal in your stocking this Christmas.
No, not really. This season, we don't want you to worry about work or school. So for some relaxing opportunities around the community, we go to Thomas Hines.
Hello, this is Thomas Hines reporting for Wildcat TV. As the holidays are quickly arriving upon us, there are many Christmas events around the Blue Springs area that can be family-friendly and will get your Christmas spirit up and going. First, there is the Christmas Charity event at Blue Springs 8 Theater located on North 7 Highway. Starting on Saturday, December 14th, each Saturday leading up to Christmas Day, Blue Springs 8 is offering free movies to anyone who donates a toy to the children at Drum Farm. The toy must be at least $10 from a family of five in order to enjoy your free Christmas film. If you have more than 5 family members, you may bring in 2 canned goods for each additional person that will go to harvesters. Come up on any Saturday from 10 a.m. to noon and donate a generous gift to a child in need. Coming up on December 15th, the Dillingham Lewis Museum in downtown Blue Springs will be holding the event Shades of Christmas Past, which will have Christmas decorations all over the museum. Come down every Sunday from 1 to 4 p.m., every Thursday 5 to 8 p.m., and on Monday the 23rd from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. There is no admission required, but please bring a donation. It's a great way to study the fascinating history of Blue Springs while also getting into the Christmas spirit. All of these events are a great way to get into the Christmas spirit with your friends and family, and a great way to serve the community. From Wildcat TV, I'm Thomas Hines, and I wish you all a Merry Christmas.
Thanks, Thomas. Those events look like a fantastic time, perfect for the whole family.
No more hat, Eli?
Yeah, Marble got kind of mad.
We're going to take a quick commercial break, but when we come back, we're going to look at 2 things that everyone loves during the holiday season, music and movies. So be sure to stay tuned or you'll be seeing a lot of this during Christmas.
Jared.
What?
Stop with the cold.
Sorry.
We'll be right back.
Hey Wildcats, Matt Mitchell here at Culver's. How do I look? It's spirit wear time, guys. This fall, any Friday night, between 5 o'clock and close, just come to Culver's and receive 10% off your order when you wear your spirit gear. It could be a shirt, it could be a hat, whatever spirit wear you have, just come to Culver's. Show them your spirit wear. You get 10% off whatever you want to order. Come before the game, come after the game. It's all delicious. You can come in and get your favorite items and receive 10% off your entire order.
Though many of you know the program we are currently watching is Wildcat TV, it does have a counterpart that we in South co-host known as BSSD Radio. For details on all the holiday classics, we go to Will Hampshire.
Behind me are the windows to the BSSD Radio's Wildcat studio, and as of right now, they are playing 24/7 holiday classics on 10:30 a.m. Let's go in and go check it out.
I asked Blake Terrence to explain what BSSD Radio is doing for this time of the year.
BSSD Radio is the only online radio station in the Kansas City area that broadcasts Christmas music from November 1st to January 1st. And you can tune in to bssdradio.net 24/7 to hear all the Christmas tunes. You can tune into 10:30 a.m. KCWJ from 3 to 4 on Mondays and Tuesdays to hear the BSSD Radio Hour, Blue Springs High School broadcast, and then Wednesdays and Thursdays is the Blue Springs South broadcast. So BSSD Radio is a great way to broadcast the most popular music and the voice of the student body.
Now over Christmas break, you can listen to all the Christmas music you'd like on BSSD Radio on 10:30 a.m. and on bssdradio.net. Signing off for Wildcat TV, I'm Will Hampshire. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Will. I'm sure it won't be a silent night listening to BSSD Radio over the break.
Songs are a big part of America's Christmas culture. Its biggest contender, however, is the cinema.
Wildcat TV counts down our top 5 Christmas movies that you should watch over the break. So strap on your seatbelts and get ready to go on a cinematic sleigh ride. Coming in at number 5, we have Home Alone. This movie may not be the first that comes to mind during the holiday season, but it's a classic tale about a frantic boy that gets left home alone while his family goes on a Christmas vacation to Paris. Try not to actually be home alone when you watch this. It's much more fun with the family. The 4th movie on our list is not as well known by our generation, but this heartwarming story has stood the test of time. The 1946 film, It's a Wonderful Life, is the story of George Bailey when he wishes he had never been born, and his wish comes true. After seeing how much of an impact he has had on people, he has a change of heart. This movie is one you definitely want to watch over the break. Movie number 3 on our countdown is one you have probably heard of before. National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation is the comedic classic starring the always laughable Chevy Chase as the father of the Griswold family as they make a trip to meet the in-laws for Christmas. Needless to say, things don't go as planned. The Polar Express is the second movie on our list. This incredibly lifelike animated film tells the story of a boy who has his doubts about the existence of Santa Claus. He gets the chance to ride on a very special train to the North Pole called the Polar Express. This movie is relatable to all of us as it shows how we transition from our childhood to our teen years and our belief in the bearded man in the big red suit. Now for the top movie on our list. Drum roll please. And the winner is... Elf. This Christmas comedy starring Will Ferrell juxtaposed as an elf when he discovers he's not really one of Santa's pointy-eared workers, and he must travel to New York City to discover who he truly is. This Christmas flick is fun for all ages, and if you're looking for a good laugh during the holidays, this movie is a must-see.
Those are some terrific movies. My personal favorite is... Hey, where'd you get that?
The Polar Express?
They've got it?
Yeah, they've got it.
All right, well, we're going to take a hot chocolate break. But when we come back, we're going to give you a couple of gifts. Though, just like any other good gift, we aren't going to give any hints. So stay tuned, we'll be right back.
All new leather seats in every auditorium.
All new digital projectors.
We have the newest in 3D capabilities. Now that's what I'm talking about.
All new digital surround sound like you never heard before.
All new popcorn machine with real butter.
We have the lowest concession prices in the whole area.
And all new affordable ticket prices. The lobby is even new.
Yeah, these are new too.
As promised, we have a couple of gifts for you, but first, let's take a look at this week's announcements. PSAT scores can be picked up for Mrs. Finley during Wildcat Hour in the North Computer Lab in the Media Center.
Once again, you can follow BSHS on Twitter. Get updates on school events and activities at Wildcats BSHS.
Seniors interested in the A-plus program who have not signed up, you must apply by the end of first semester to be eligible. A-semester release students who plan to use A-plus money need to stop by the A-plus office ASAP to fill out an intent to access benefits form.
Any girl interested in participating in girls track and field in the spring needs to see Coach Reeder for calendar and preseason workout information. They will start preseason workouts the week we get back from Christmas break.
Seniors, check our school website often for available scholarship applications and opportunities. Go to www.bssd.net, click on Schools, High Schools, and Blue Springs.
The Literary Illusions Book Club will meet next on Wednesday, January 15th during Wildcat Hour Shift A in the Library Media Center. The book for this month is Winter Girls. For your first gift, we're going to go to Reyven Lawrence.
Hey Wildcats, it's Reyven Lawrence here with my special guest, Sienna Marble. We're going to teach you how to make these snow globes. What we're going to need for this craft are some glitter, two mason jars or baby jars. We have the super glue. We have different types of ribbons to decorate the front of it. We have little figurines. And of course, we need our water. So the first thing we're going to do, Sienna, we're going to take these two jars and we're going to fill it up with water. We're going to fill it up almost to the top, but not quite. Now, what we're going to do is, yes, we're going to get our glitter and we're going to take off the packets. So which two are you going to use? Okay, we're going to use white and silver for hers to get the snow effect that we have for our snow globe. And I'm just going to use the plain white one. So what we're going to do is we're going to open them. And make sure you have something laying down so it doesn't make a big mess. Okay, so what we're going to do is, you want to pour it for me? Oh, we're going to wait for that. Because when we shake it, that's when it's going to stir all together. And then add a very little, like barely any. And stop. There you go. Okay, So next, are you ready for the fun part? So next, what we're gonna do is once you pick out our Christmas figurine, we're going to glue it to the lid of our mason jar. So we'll take the glue. Be careful with the super glue because it is very hard to come off the skin or clothing or anything else. So once it's all dry, I'm gonna turn it so that it's shut really tight because you don't want any water to come out. I'm gonna shake it. You like that? Yeah. Okay. So Sienna, what do you think so far?
Pretty.
Really pretty?
Pretty.
I love yours. Okay. To make it a little bit more Christmassy, what we're gonna do is we're going to cut some ribbon. Make sure when you collar around, you have safety scissors in adult supervision or someone watching over them so they don't cut themselves. So, okay, you want to cut it?
I want two different ribbons. Yeah, and then the other and the
red.
Tie them together.
So, after we have our two ribbons cut out, we're going to glue the back of them so that it can stick to the rim of the top. And then, what we're going to do is we're going to tie a knot, okay? So can you tie a knot for me?
I don't know how.
Okay, I'll do it for you. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take our other one, and we're going to glue the back of that, okay? Okay. I'm going to take it, and you're going to put it on top of the green one. Is that okay with you? Okay. You're going to tie another knot. Like that? You like it? So how did you like this craft, Sienna?
Good.
Was it easy?
Yeah.
Who are you going to give yours to?
My mom and my daddy.
Your mommy and daddy? I hope they like it. You think they'll like it?
Yeah, my sister.
Okay.
You can put it in the middle of the table.
Thank you for joining us as Sienna and I make this wonderful Christmas craft. Sienna and I would like to wish you all a Merry Christmas.
That looks like a fantastic craft. Thank you for the gift, Reyven.
For your last gift, we're going to go to Gunnar Strickland. Though not for sports, but instead for story time.
Well, hello, Wildcats. It's story time with Gunnar Strickland. Now, it's a joyous time of the year. So I'm going to tell you the time that I almost caught Santa Claus. I'm going to give you a few tips. You write these tips down because they come in handy. You listen to them very detailed, and you will catch Santa Claus.
To begin your night, you must find a comfortable couch. Adjust yourself, get a nice cool and warm blanket. Take off your slippers as you sit and wait for Mr. C to arrive. Make sure you have a nice hot glass of hot chocolate, if that's what you want, and turn on your favorite Christmas movie to enjoy. As the night progresses, you're going to need to get the cookies and milk for Mr. St. Nick to enjoy as he travels around the world to bring you gifts. You mustn't forget the carrots for the reindeers. Rudolph loves a good carrot. I say this, and I mean this. This is where I went wrong. You mustn't get too comfortable or you fall asleep, wishing of sugar plum fairies as the night awaits. As I realized, I had fallen asleep waiting for St. Nick. What do I see? I see a letter from him? Santa Claus left me a letter? What does it say?
Dear Gunnar, you are the closest anyone has ever gotten to catching me. Don't tell anyone about your tips. If it leaves your lips, I'm going to have to put you on the naughty list. Ho, ho, ho!
And that is the night I almost caught Santa Claus.
Thanks for the tips, Gunnar. I will make sure to follow them closely. This is Eli.
And this is Jared saying it's a great day
to take a holiday. On behalf of everyone here, happy holidays, Merry Christmas, and a Happy New Year.